1929. Okay, something new happened, and I make a decision. I made it rather a couple of minutes ago, but nonetheless, I think it's a good decision. And the decision is to stop, think about some stupidity and start to really work with your thinking. By your, I mean, of course, mine. What do I mean by that? I mean that I will not publish these videos in YouTube or in anywhere else at all. Stop. Now I'm going to talk only for myself. It means I can talk everything. There is no necessity to be afraid that, oh, it will be said stupidly or something like that. Okay, it doesn't matter because it's only for me. I'm talking for myself. I know that it helps me. I know how can I use it. Because when I talked to myself, but when I assumed that it will be published, I never talk seriously. I mean, of course, I talk seriously sometimes, but by seriousness, I mean something deep. I couldn't talk something deep because it's like it's unconscious. You can't, your unconsciousness can't show itself while you assume that it will be shown to someone else. And now I'm certainly sure that I will use this exercise only for myself. I will not publish it, even if I make it, I don't know, even if I make it, yeah, maybe if I make it, for example, if I finish some long sequence as, let's say, 1,000 recordings, I can say, oh, it was great, it's the whole way I've gone through and I learned language through this way. Now I can talk, I can talk perfectly, I am the best speaker in the world. In that case, probably I will show it, but actually there is no any intention to publish these videos. It's only for myself. It means I will talk more, not just once per day at morning. No, I will try to talk as fast as I can, as many times as I can. Right, and the purpose of that these talks will be just training your thinking, because at the beginning I'm not going to think about the content of my speech at all. I just going to put the camera, and every time when I put it, I have to say something meaningful. Meaningful for myself. I mean, I can talk about my routine. I can describe my superficial thoughts. I can describe my deep thoughts if it's possible. Now I think it's a good way to start from philosophy, because really I want to talk about philosophy. I don't worry about I always don't worry about philosophy either, but it's like some interesting topic for me. I like to think about philosophy. I like to read philosophic books. I like to think about philosophers like Kant, Nietzsche, Schopenhauer, Aristotle, Plato, and so on. Really, it's a great way to develop your thoughts by thinking about something important for you. And philosophy for me important because I consider myself as a kind of philosopher. What am I doing in life? I'm reading books. I'm trying to find some important knowledge. I'm trying to think about it. I'm trying to write it. I'm trying to make it available not only for me and for philosophers, but also for people I'm communicated with. Really, it's part of my life, and it's important to focus my attention on this thing, because Without focusing attention, it's hard even to start to think about philosophy. I can talk the whole year, and I will talk about, I don't know, reading, speaking, writing, thinking. But if I don't focus on philosophy, it's hard to think about philosophy, to come to the point when it will be necessary to talk about philosophy. Okay, philosophy. What do I know about philosophy? That's the first question I should answer here and now. I know not so much, but I've read so many books. I've tried to think during 5, 10. No, I actually started thinking maybe from which point I started to think. Somewhere between 2011 and 2012, I started to think in that period. It's like 6 years, really. And I developed my thinking during that period of time. And I can say that philosophy is all about thinking. It's not about anything else, about the world. Consist of ideas or material things. It doesn't matter at all, because all of you can call idea, it also can be something represented in material stuff, and all of you can call material stuff also can be represented in idea. But usually if you use words all about ideas, they are not real at all. I mean, if we delete everything, every existed words and describe things in a different way, we can get completely different way of two languages, right? English and Russian. I know two languages, and somehow they have some correlative points, but actually they don't. It's a completely different languages, and I use different words to call different things, and they both right. I mean, if I say it's the camera and at a camera, it will be the same. Okay, camera is like camera, the same word. Okay, it's a floor. I'm standing on the floor. It's one sentence. Я стою на полу.